Welcome and a quick ground level view of the domestic terminal. And then we'll go up to the air, the space, and go to Mumbai Airport. Welcome to Mumbai Airport, the Chhatrapati Shivaji International Airport area. And here is the aerial view of the Mumbai Airport. This area, which I am showing now, is in general called the Chhatrapati Shivaji International Airport area. This is the north side and this is the southern side. And Mumbai Chhatrapati Shivaji Airport has got two intersecting runways. The main runway, runway 0927, running east-west here. This is the east side and this is the west side towards the sea, 12,000 feet long. And the secondary runway, which is running northwest-southeast and 9,800 feet long and runs here across the thing. You have the international terminal with an approach from the Sahar side. This is the Mumbai T2 terminal and this is the international terminal. And here you have the Mumbai domestic terminal or the T1, which is an approach from the National Highway 8 on the Villaparle side. This is the Juhu Airport, which is sometimes mistaken by pilots to be the Mumbai Airport, and in fact one pilot landed in the Juhu Airport. This is the Arabian Sea that you have. Now, when in Mumbai, this runway 0927 running east-west is the main operational single runway, and generally aircrafts land and take off from this westerly east to west direction. That is, from here they will take off and the planes coming here comes here and then lands it. The secondary runway, which is the northwest southeast, is used only in the case of this runway shut down for whatever may be the reason. So at one point of time both the runways were tried being operational simultaneously, but it didn't prove to be very effective compared to running a single runway. Now, let me just take you to a closer look and then explain the features of the terminal. The Mumbai Airport came into operation in the year 19. Let's go and have a close look at the domestic terminal T1. That's the domestic terminal T1. And here is the approach road from the National Highway 8. You come in there and then get into this arrival and departure route. This is how we enter into the terminal. This is the terminal complex where the check-in counters are located, and you cross the security, which are all housed here, and then come into the boarding gates this side. This has a history. Originally, this terminal was Terminal 1A, 1B and 1C, but now everything has been amalgamated and called one Terminal 1. This side of Terminal 1, which I've called the A gates, I've got 11 gates. This is the 6-7 gates of the C gates, and then you have additional 11 non-aero bridge parking spaces at this area. So totally you have about 11 plus 11, 22 plus 7, 29 gates in Mumbai Airport. And now let's go down to the ground level and get some nice views of the terminal from both inside, and on a bus ride under the aero bridges here, take a turn as we see here, come back here and then go for the aircraft that is parked here. It's a very nice drive. I'm sure that you will enjoy that bus ride. We will get on from one of those manual gates here and then go under these bridges. As you can see the pathway, come out and then take down, and we run parallel to the runway. So let's do that, and then we will go to the terminal T2 and give you some inputs on that T2. our bus tour starts now. We are moving under the gates, the A gates, which have the 11 of them. The numbers are marked A1 to A11, and you will see them on the pillar now. This will be, the coming up would be A6, I think. Yes, A6. And you can see the aircrafts at the multi-aircraft with swing arms. So we are moving towards the end of the A gates, and we will take a complete U-turn and we'll have these aero bridges onto our right, and they'll give you a very nice view. Indigo going on the taxiway towards the runway end, and then now we will take a turn now. Yes, that's the circle and which we will take a turn. Run now parallel to the aircraft. This was a very unusual thing with the jet with the spice jet parked right at the farther end of the A gates, and now you can see that we are passing through the Mumbai Airport Terminal 2 or the International Domestic Terminal T2. Now, as of effective 2016, all international flights departed and arrived at Terminal T2, in addition to the domestic flights of Air India and Vistara Airlines. In 2019, when the defunct Jet Airways dissolved its operations, some of the flights of Indigo, Spice and Go Air, the long distance metro flights, were shifted to Terminal T2. Approach to Terminal T2 is from the National Highway 8 through an elevated expressway which connects the Sahar entrance. Formerly it was known as the Sahar Road. Now it is known as Sahar Elevated Road and Airport Road, and you can access. The terminal is occupying about 450,000 square meters of space, multi-level terminal in four floors, two floors departure and arrival, which are occupied in level 2, 3 and 4, and it has both the aero bridges and the remote stands. The important thing about this terminal is these aero bridges are what are known as multiple aircraft ramp system. That means each gate is designed with a ramp stand which can accommodate multiple aircraft. That means one wide-bodied aircraft or two smaller aircraft like a Boeing 737, 8320, etc. And it has got swing gates so that two aircrafts can pass, park like this. Like you see here, there is a wide-body aircraft and one smaller aircraft. And so here as well. So this is multi-aircraft ramp system with swing gates. The terminal is X-shaped, looking like an X, but restricted on this side due to the existing properties here, and this side due to the taxiway and runway. Otherwise, it would have resembled a normal X multiple level terminal. It has got a lot of retail space, shops, etc., and many number of escalators and travelators along the path to carry passengers easily from one end to another to the central concourse and then exit from the runway. So that is as far as the international terminal is concerned. Now let's see how aircraft's movements are there. So aircraft movements from this terminal is through one of these areas. You come down onto the exit ways and then go onto the runway at the end here and take off. And taking off, landing aircrafts can take the earliest exit somewhere here, come all the way into here and then go in, or take one of these exits and then come into the terminal. So this terminal was opened on 2014 for operations, and it's a wonderful terminal constructed by Larsen and Toubro and designed by Skidmore and Company. So that is as far as the Mumbai Airport International Terminal. Let's take a takeoff view of Mumbai Airport from runway 0927. You have on your right the terminal 3. You take off from here like the aircraft and then roll forward and go across the 1432 and then cross the domestic terminal. On your right, and then take off into the sea. That's how normally the planes take off, and then they make a complete, sometimes a turn, either to the right or to the other couple. Now let's get into an aircraft, and then have the feeling of actual takeoff from the runway 0927. We are coming here and then take off from runway 0927 today. It's a spice jet flight, and brace yourself for some wonderful action. We see an aircraft landing on 0927 through the window. And then there is one aircraft right in front of us in Jet Airways flight. And after that, it will be our turn to take off. Runway 0927 taking off from the east side towards the west onto the sea. Another Jet Airways aircraft behind us, and an Indigo behind Jet Airways in the queue to take off after us. Now let's see the action on the runway. The Jet Airways picks up speed and rolls down on the runway. Zero nine two seven. There, it's taken off. And this is JCA's flight to London, departing from Mumbai early in the morning. Another aircraft landing. Touchdown, and then we move now to take off. We take that right turn into the runway. Full turn. You can see T2 on the right now. We are now at the very end of the eastern end of the runway. There we roll off. T2 on the right there, you can see. The starch X-shaped terminal. And the 1432 we just crossed. The domestic remote and the domestic air bridges, the control tower, and your airborne. View of T1 A gates, and we bank to the right towards the sea. That's the NH8 below. Juhu Airport on your right. And then on to the sea. Thank you very much. Hope you liked it. Comment, subscribe, and thank you again.